Legend of Total War here, and I'm with Simpsy, and this is a co-op campaign for Total War Attila. How's it going, Simpsy?
Yeah, right. How are you?
Yeah, good.
We're playing.
Yeah.
Yep, we're playing as the Eastern Roman Empire and the Sassanids.
Yep, me being the Eastern Empire. So we're not going head to head this time. Well, not that we've done head to head before, because the head to heads I think in Attila are a bit boring.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
End up just with AI death. Like if you've watched the campaign between me and Soul Games Inc., we weren't exactly enjoying it. And he was telling me that he was playing a co-op campaign with you, and that mm-hmm. it was actually fun.
Yeah.
So we're playing for fun more than anything else here, and also good conversation.
Sure. Especially with that head to head, you guys were just avoiding each other the whole time. Just
we never
running
touched
around.
Each other once.
That's what she said.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess.
Sick.
Yes.
Right. I'm in now.
He did get raped at sea, though.
True.
Not by me. Which is annoying, because I wanted to do the raping. Then again, I got raped by the Romans.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so.
Okay, we're in.
You're in first.
Right, firstly, when you get trade rights with you, boost up my economy naturally. I need to see what relations are with the Western Rome. It might be alright.
I don't think you'd be able to trade with them anyway, because you've got no clear path to get to them.
Yeah. No, I don't. But they are neutral. It's not too bad. Alright.
If you can manage to, like, conquer your way up to Crimea, that'll give you a port by which you could trade with Rome.
Mm-hmm. I think that's probably the best thing for me. I can subjugate a lot more regions to the north.
Yeah.
Alright. Military-wise, I think I'm going to go with military to get some better quality units. Right, objective-wise, I'll just show you guys. What is it? I need 16 more puppets. We basically smashed everything else. Maintain 400 units. We currently have 109 and 16 technology. So this campaign and series, I wouldn't imagine, would go for very long.
It'll be a fun and quick one. Quick, fun campaign. We'll have a few cool battles and then call it a day.
Awesome. Right, okay.
I mean, guys, if you're looking for me to have a hard time in a campaign, check out the Western Roman Empire campaign.
Jesus.
I'm sweating bullets on that one. Is there any campaign you're having a tough time with?
I was at the start with the Danes campaign.
Yeah.
That was pretty hard, but I pushed through. I finished
That's
my Western...
That's
what
she said.
Oh, God. Cheers.
It was pretty hard, but I pushed through. The anus. Okay, are you done your stuff?
No, man. I'm just quickly going through my buildings. Alright.
So, yeah. Obviously, you guys don't know this because our video is screwed up. But this is actually our third attempt at starting this campaign. D-Sinks.
Biggest pain in the ass.
Yeah. That's not what she said.
My God, this is...
Okay. That's
superb.
Enough of that. We're going to...
This commentary is fucking sick, eh?
Yeah. You started the she said stuff.
Yeah, I know. God damn it.
And I tend to overkill these things, beat it right to the ground.
It's fine. Right, okay. Where are you pushing these bastards? My public order was real shit last time when I moved out, so I might not move everyone. Alright, quickly reform these armies, and I'll throw it back to you. Alright, that looks alright. Onigas here. What have I got? Light Onigas. Since when did I have Onigas? Alright.
All I have to say is, why would the Eastern Empire have allowed the Visigoths to enter into this area?
Is it, like, so far deep as well? Don't you fucking dare! Don't you fucking...
On the move, my lord! Oh, I didn't even need to say it that time.
Oh, I was so angry with myself.
Yep.
Right. I might need to put one more provincial governor in. Go with the minus corruption. Sanitation not really needed overly that much.
No, you don't need any sanitation buildings. All you need to do is take provincial capitals and then you'll be all good. I don't know how many provinces there are in the game, but let's just say there's 60 of them. So if the Sassanids take 60 provinces, they've got 60 sanitation in all settlements.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they'd probably have something like 140% corruption, but whatever.
True. Okay. It's your turn, mate. Mate? Jesus. What? Didn't even mean to do that.
What'd you do?
I don't know. It just sounded really Australian, I think.
Well, that's okay. Do you feel like you have to dial it down? Dial down the Aussie when you're talking to Soul Games Inc. or something?
No. Not necessarily. I don't know. Do I have that much of an Australian accent?
I don't know. It's a bit. I can tell it's like if I walked by you in the street, go, he's definitely Australian.
Yeah.
I guess.
I don't know.
I feel like I don't have as much of an Australian accent as some people do.
I could definitely tell you were a Queenslander by your accent. I don't know why. Yeah, okay. Yeah, easy.
I've been told otherwise. But yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Maybe I've been told that by other Queenslanders.
True.
Yeah, and then there's also Bogan. Do you guys have Bogans in Tasmania, apart from inbreds?
We have Bogan inbreds.
Yeah. Oh, wow, Bogan inbreds, man, they must be fucked.
They are super fucked.
I'm sure there's viewers watching, they're like, what the hell's a Bogan?
Mm-hmm.
Just use your imagination or Google it, that's all I can say.
What's the equivalent? A chav in the UK, maybe?
I don't know. It's somebody who is at the bottom barrel of the evolutionary pit. Somebody who is on welfare, has no teeth, consumes alcohol for fuel, and has many, 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 many children.
Has a wife beater.
Yep, what and he got? Beats his wife.
Yep.
Oh, I guess you guys don't realize it. I'm getting rid of course, Christianity again. Because not only do I not like it in real life, but I don't like it in the game either. But to be honest, if it was better in the game, I'd leave it. But it gives the Huns a huge advantage over us. Okay, so we need governors.
So, controversial. Did you have a religious upbringing? Like,
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
I have since unshackled myself from it.
Yeah. Is it Catholic?
Of course it is.
Yeah, same here.
What else would it be? I think Australia is the most Catholic, most also unshackled Catholic country there is.
Yeah.
Like, you just walk down the street. Did you used to be Catholic? Yep. Used to being the key word. My whole family used to be Catholic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, same. It's interesting.
Yeah. Don't have a problem with Christians. I don't want to get too much into
it. Yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah. It's a sensitive subject for most.
Fuck it.
Yeah. Oh, right, I've already got 4 out of 4 governors, right. That's why I can't get more. Gonna get more Imperium, which will make people hate me. Oh, speaking of Imperium, or people liking me, let's see, trade routes. I can get one with Abascia, possibly. Good. High successes. Let's give me some cash, say about 1,100. So did you have to do the whole Catholic school, go to church every Sunday?
I wasn't that bad with going... Oh, Yeah, not as bad as like full on. But I did go to a Catholic school.
Yep, so did I. Primary school and secondary school.
Yep.
And forced to go to church every Sunday. Stand up, sit down, kneel, sit down, stand up, kneel, sing, go home.
Yeah.
Fuck, it's over.
I didn't have to go to church every Sunday. Just on like special occasions and stuff.
Oh, okay. No, it was in one of those families where it was guilt. It's just like, oh, if you did anything, you got to go to confession.
So it was full on.
It wasn't 100% full on. It was more full on when I was a kid, I suppose.
Yeah.
But naughty shit that I was, I was always in trouble. And it always used to piss me off when I'd get, like, because I would say something like, I don't want to go to church today. And then I would lose my computer privileges. Which is like the easiest way to make me have a tantrum.
Yeah.
You can probably imagine that I was a shit of a chid. Kid.
A chid.
Chid.
I had football on Sunday, so I got out of it mostly.
Yeah. My parents made the mistake of putting me on a computer when I was 5 years old. And then they were like, we can't get him off.
What have we done?
What have we done? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm, of course, the eldest, so I was the big bully of the out of five.
Yeah?
Yep.
I'm the eldest out of four.
Yep. It's good to be the eldest.
It's fucking sick.
Yeah. What am I doing? Okay, now I need food.
So what's your background then? As an Australian? Ethnic? Yeah, ethnic, I mean.
Half Maltese, half everything else.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Like, there's a bit of Scottish, there's a bit of Dutch.
Yeah.
There's a bit of English. Bit of this, bit of that.
Yep.
Yeah. So, I've been to Malta.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it. Okay, so I'm trying to fix up the food in all my regions. Because I've got, like I said to you before, regions that are importing food lose 25% of their wealth. So it's important to fix that up straight away. Also, the more food surplus you have, the more growth you get in all of your provinces. But I'm sure you don't already know that.
Yep. All good.
How many hours you clocked on Attila?
180, I think.
Yeah, okay.
You had that within like the first couple of days. I was keeping count. I was looking at it.
Yeah, but to be honest, what I did was I never turned my computer off. So I like...
Oh, okay. Just
like,
left it on.
I'd be there at like 11 o'clock at night and then I'd be in the middle of a game or a video and I'd just press end the video and then I'd be like, going to bed, and I'd just walk straight to the bed. Didn't even bother turning off the computer. And then, of course, when I wake up, I'm like, oh, man, I'm fucked. And then I come to the computer. It's like, oh, good. It's still here. Pick it up. Sometimes I don't even have breakfast. It's like, oh, I got to get my total war going. And, of course, I only sleep for like 4 hours, of which I dream about killing.
Which you dream about total war?
Yeah. It's 24 hours total war.
Hella.
In the middle of the act, and I'm like, slaughter them. Instead of, okay, that doesn't even make sense. That's actually not what happens.
What are you doing your turn-wise?
Turn-wise? What am I doing?
Mm.
I'm building stuff.
Okay.
I've actually got a lot more money than the previous ones because I managed to get more trading units. It all just depends on how much they like you to begin with. Oh, actually, the francs say medium. I probably won't worry about them. I'm not going to pay them any cash.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to milk the AI for money in this. That's what Man's Soul found out.
Yeah, and now I'm just going through destroying things that I don't want, like rally fields.
Because what we... Yeah.
Military jetty, I don't think I need that.
Because we were playing as the Ostrogoths and the Visigoths. We fled to Africa. Everyone loved us. We were getting 2,000 per faction. Easy. So we're getting like nearly 10,000 per every five turns.
Oh god, cog's so crazy. Easy.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about, like, the thing is, as the Eastern Empire, the Sassanids are your biggest threat.
Yeah.
And now I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah. And, yeah, like I said, oh well. I can give you money if you need to, and if you need an army, I can come over and help.
The thing is, I'm too proud to ask for money, and I'm too greedy to share any with you. Seriously, you will find me to be your worst ally ever. Okay, I'm done with my turn. I think I might just hire a few extra units. I've got plenty of money coming in, but cavalry's more. That doesn't matter. That'll be fine. Edicts. I forgot about the edicts. So I'm going for food production and well and growth, because that's important that we get those building slots going.
Is that a resource at Constantinopolis? That cross.
What?
Is that a resource?
A patriarchal sea.
And what's that exactly?
Well, there are. You Catholic and you don't even know about the Pentarchy.
No, as in, like, the game.
Well, it's based off history. There are five patriarchal seats.
Like, what are the bonuses?
Seats. Basically, there's five seats of Christianity. There's Alexandria. So that's the Coptic Christians. There's. I think Jerusalem's supposed to be the other one, but they've renamed it to Aelia Capitolina here. Mm-hmm. There's Antioch, there's Constantinople, and then there's Rome. The five seats of... Basically, the five popes.
Yep.
And the Byzantine Empire has four of them. Rome has the fifth.
And what bonuses do you get from that? Do you get any?
Well, it allows you to build the Christian major building, the Greek Patriarchal See.
Yeah.
So, the Greek Patriarchal See gives you access to religious influence, one state religion, all regions. But since I'm getting rid of Christianity,
it's going to be useless.
It makes useless. Anyway, moving on to your turn. Yeah, the main reason to get rid of Christianity in this is, for one thing, the buildings are really expensive, and secondly, the Huns just wreck Christians.
Hmm.
Right. Okay, so we're getting attacked here. So this is...
Third time's a charm.
Third time, this is it. If we can get through this, we'll be doing well.
If not, I'm just going to flip shit.
Pop a new topic on you. You've been following the shit that's been going down in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. I have been.
Man, people are flipping out over that crap.
I know. What, do you want to know my opinion on it?
Oh, do you want to know my opinion first?
Yeah.
I don't care that they got killed.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'll just keep everyone up to date. Basically, there was a bunch of Australian drug smugglers that got caught in Indonesia. In Indonesia, the penalty for being caught for drugs-related things is often the death penalty. So the two ringleaders got... after being in prison for, like, 10 years...
What was that? Why 10 years?
I don't know. I guess they want to rehabilitate them before they kill them.
Because that makes sense.
Yeah.
But anyway... Go on. Yeah,
they've been trying for ages and ages to get clemency. They didn't get it. And pretty much, I think it was yesterday, they were shot dead. And I don't care. Basically,
fair enough.
The rest of Australia is just flipping the shit out over this crap.
Yeah, I agree with that. It's just fucked. The amount of people just Facebook statuses and newsfeed is just full of shit.
I know. Like, to be honest... I don't know, it's hard to say, like, I kind of support the death penalty for things, but drug-related crimes is, like, not one of them.
And, they were importing to Australia, they got caught in Australia. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know they got actually caught in Australia. No, I thought Australian authorities tipped them off.
Oh.
Tipped off the,
Yeah, because apparently, Andrew Chan managed to smuggle over $2 million from Indonesia to Australia.
Yeah.
So, but they were the masterminds to it.
Yeah. I also found it funny that they made amends for their ways, or they became better people mm-hmm. once they were in jail, not before.
Yeah.
Sort of thing. I don't know. Like, I mean, you got to understand, like, everyone knows that in Indonesia... Especially after Chappelle Corby crap.
Mm-hmm.
If you pull any drug shit over there, you're going to risk your life. Yeah, I'll give you these three.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of against the death penalty, but I just...
Wuss.
Yeah.
That's all right.
I don't know. I just feel like it was kind of a waste. For drugs as well. Like,
yeah, look, for drugs,
but they did risk
I understand
it.
That, yeah.
The penalty has to fit the crime, but they were fucking idiots.
I think, like I said, I support the death penalty for mm-hmm. murderers and rapists.
Yeah, because that makes sense.
Yeah, but like, for drugs, which I don't really consider to be, like, the worst thing that's ever been invented.
Yeah, same. But then the counter-argument to that is how many lives would they destroy? Like, I've saw people, saying that.
Yes, technically, but...
That's just stupid.
You can understand that people take their own life when they have drugs, sort of.
Yeah. Right, wow, touche. Right, at least we can see in this battle.
Yeah, this is the first time it was foggy, shitty. Second time it was really rainy.
Yeah. Right, where are the reinforcements?
Archers are in really loose formation, which I don't like. I want them to tighten up. Wait a second. I got an idea. Get them in there.
Right.
Oh, they've got to go all the way around.
Do you have any questions about Tasmania?
What's there to know, apart from you're all inbreds?
Yep, there's I'm not even joking. There's actually inbreds here.
Yep.
Like, honestly. I'll tell you a story, I guess. My mum used to work as a nurse down in Hobart.
Is she is she just your mum, or is she also your sister?
Ugh.
Sorry.
Fuck, that derailed me. Yeah, but no, there's actually like a little inbred colony. And they like live in the bush in their own little community. And they have to drink lots of water for some reason. Okay. It's like, they're like so inbred. Like, they have to drink like 6 liters of water a day or something stupid.
Why? Because they've got like holes in their skin. They've actually got gills that like pour out.
But yeah, no, honestly, there actually are inbreds here. It's proper fucked.
I believe you.
I'm not inbred. I'm fucking... Well, now me saying that questions it.
How do we know you're not inbred?
Oh, I don't have two heads.
Oh, okay. Because, I don't think anybody gets two heads when they're inbred. They like just get... They get a little bit extra or a little bit less.
Right, are these cohorts firing? They should be, they're not in range. I'll move them up. Are they in range?
Crap. Well, I'll tell you, in Queensland, we don't have mm-hmm. inbreds. We, of course, have bogans. I'm sure you got bogans as well. But what we have is shriveled up prunes.
We have bogan inbreds.
Yeah, that's... Wow. That's...
In Australia, you're about to say. I'm used to it. We're technically connected, I think, under the sea.
Yeah, not connected by land.
We were connected.
When?
A while ago.
What, like when the Aboriginals first got here?
No, as in, like, geographically, a long time ago, before it split.
Yeah,
like... Not that long ago. Like
40,000 years, wasn't it?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
We're connected under the sea.
So is everyone.
Mm.
We're connected to bloody the USA by the sea.
Hey.
The sea.
Okay.
It's just much, much, much deeper.
Can you move your archers up a bit so I can move the cohorts in to get some shots off? Because if I put them in front of yours...
Well, they're kind of doing something.
Yeah.
They're also obstructed, sort of.
Yeah.
Where's this guy? I need to get him over here.
I was trying to think where I can get these cohorts to skirmish just a bit more.
Yeah, I'm going to get my cavalry around the other side.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
My archers.
Those archers will be able to rinse through there.
Because what I got to do is kill their general, but I can't really get to him.
Where's their other one deploying? They're flanking quite heavily now. From that side.
Yeah, have you come to Queensland? You've been to Queensland before, haven't you?
Yeah, I go to Queensland about once every year. Go to the Sunshine Coast because my uncle lives there.
Your uncle? Or is he also your brother?
Oh, he's my dad.
Okay, right. Okay.
It could be my son, I don't know.
Uncle's son? How the hell does that work?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Okay, hang on. Your uncle is your brother's child. So if he's also your son, you had sex with your brother. No, or your sister.
Oh, no. Oh, cousin.
I don't even know how inbreeding works. You're going to have to explain it to me. Sort of.
Fuck.
Okay, see, I've got my archers here on this sweet little angle here. You can see up there in the...
You just need to hope for a lucky shot if you can hit that general.
Yeah, plus the artillery's now hitting these guys up here, which is going to be far less accurate.
They're going to be breaking the wall mostly compared to your units.
That wall can't break, it's indestructible.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just like fucking idiots.
I need you to push more troops down there.
Get them to attack.
Yeah, you can't let them... Don't let them get up here. Don't let them take the tower, because a lot of these Libertania are about to break and die.
Do you want to put into Testudo, or...?
Just get him down there. We're getting a bit overwhelmed here. Yeah, I'll send the general over. He needs to rally them. Shit.
Cohorts should be able to skirmish.
Oh, fuck's sake. Thought this would go a little bit better. It doesn't really matter if we do lose it, but...
How are we going? We lost 400, they've only lost 900, so...
Hang on. We can see that stuff, can't we? They've got still a lot more men than us, though. And don't forget, if we're all broken, what's that going to mean?
Are you just going to get them... Are you holding them, or are you getting them to charge?
I'm just getting them in there. Essentially, it's the cavalry that's going to do all the real damage anyway. Just gotta buy us some time, because if we kill the enemy general, we'll make the other army rout as well. Send you to go
push
there.
Them off a bit.
Oh no, that's right. Move. What's this? Gothic levy, don't worry about them. Just go all the way around the side of the settlement for the cavalry to get here, because the other motherfuckers showed up there.
How are you going on that side? It's only two lots of pikemen. The general's way. No, it's not. I thought it was.
How many kills does that artillery get? Only a few.
How well are your archers doing? 98, 60.
Yeah, they're doing pretty
70.
Well. Doing better than the Limitani. 30 kills, one of them.
Okay.
Yeah, our archers were actually getting quite a lot of kills, so it's good that we got rid of them, although they're pretty much out of ammunition.
Can you check how much the towers do? No.
No, can't check that.
Right. Their general, how many units has got that? 90.
That's in Testudo.
In Alaric. Yeah, I'll put the rest in. Should I put the other guys in Testudo?
It doesn't make a difference at the point. I think we've won. We just got to kill the enemy general, and then we're all good.
Are you surrounded? We could charge them if you halt your archers.
Okay, I'm gonna tell my archers to stop shooting. I don't think we need him. We just gotta kill the enemy general. Kill him and we've won.
I'll get him to charge.
And pull him back so we don't lose the whole battalion.
There's only 65.
He's wavering, so that's good.
Come on, you bastard. 51, the pikemen are coming in.
Still shooting, because I told him to stop.
The archers up the top are on the little clip you got going.
They should have stopped. Come on, kill that goddamn general. He's routed.
Just double time your cavalry back and get him here.
Yep, because if he dies, we win.
Right.
Not the greatest of battles, but still, getting rid of the Visigoths early on, I think, is a good move.
And Alaric's their heir, I think. Or was
we
it Alaric?
Get rid of both armies.
Alaric was their king.
The other flank over there is not holding out so well. We've got to move back over there. All the infantry... to the other flank.
We still haven't killed the general. I don't think.
Ah, what is there? One. There's two.
There's
men
two.
Left.
I'll get the explore arteries to double time. There's only two left. Come on. Piss off.
Come on, general, get over here. They need morale.
Yep, we got him.
Good. We're just going to run everyone down. We should be able to get a mass route going.
Come on, you bastards.
Hey, we've got both towers shooting over here.
Nice.
That's providing flaming shot. Also, if I use whistle shot with the archers, that'll like... Oh, wait, wrong ones. With these ones here.
Your general's about to engage. Just letting you know.
Yeah, I know.
Alright.
Alright, it's alright.
Okay.
Right over here. If they use whistling shot, it's going to cause morale penalties over everything. Come on, use the whistle shot.
They're starting to route. Let's pull back in our favor now.
We've won.
Run them down. Those onagers are still there. No, they're gone now. Nice. Let's run these bastards down.
That's the way. Alright, now we just let the cavalry do their thing. So here we go, kills wise. Oh, it says that they've got no men, but that's not true.
No.
That just means no men still fighting. They're still alive. Yep.
So we only lost, how much did we lose? 1,000. That's not too bad. Well, you lost 1,000.
Yeah, it also got to keep into account units that shattered. They count as dead men. So I don't actually lose them, though.
Yep.
Still a lot of people got to go kill. Oh, they're exhausted. They're not going to catch up.
Yeah. The towers are picking them off as well, so that's working for you.
Yep, it's all good.
All good.
Okay, let's speed this up. I'm just going to... Yeah. I doubt this is actually going to destroy their faction, but the more damage we can do to them, the better. I might be able to run them down afterwards.
Hmm. Yeah. Did you kill the other...
Well, killing both
general coming in?
Generals isn't going to do anything, really. They'll just hire more. We could actually destroy their hordes.
Yeah.
So is your family always from Tasmania?
No, mum's from Melbourne.
Oh, so you're not actually that inbred?
No, I'm only half inbred.
Oh, right. See, I'm actually from Melbourne as well.
Yeah. No, but my dad's full Tasmanian.
All right. Your dad, brother?
Yep.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, people keep ask me, like, I always complain about the heat here
mm-hmm.
in Queensland. I'm originally from Victoria, where it's actually nice.
Yeah. Yeah, Melbourne's good.
Yeah. I was just like, I remember when I was 9 years old, my parents were like, guess what, we're moving to Queensland. And I was like, fuck off.
Jesus.
Like, do you want me to die?
It is hot up there. It's hot and sticky.
It's hot and sticky.
It's really weird. Because I went to Europe last year, and it's a different heat, I swear. Like, in Italy, it's, like, not as bad as in fucking Queensland.
Yeah. I can't understand. Some people just love it here. I'm just like, what's wrong with you? Do you not sweat?
I got off the tarmac in Darwin, and my flip-flops were melting to the, like...
You call them flip-flops?
Thongs. I don't know.
You call them flip-flops because you're always talking to people from the UK. But I'm Australian, so you don't need to call them flip-flops.
Yeah, I guess I was desensitized then. Yeah, I don't know why I said flip-flops. Thongs, yeah.
We have to use different language because of people from other countries. It's all games.
Yeah.
He was calling me coward of Total War just because we kept running away from each other in our head campaign.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's okay. Only a fool fights a battle they can't win.
Alright, how are we going running them down?
I think we're done. That's good enough.
Yep.
I think a lot of them got away, but let's see.
Close victory.
Remaining 672.
They lost 3,248. And we killed Alaric.
Good. His whole army looks pretty much screwed, but I think... They might get away.
Mm-hmm.
The other army must have been the one we didn't completely destroy, because it ran very early on. Just, it would have been better, I suppose, if I had set up my cavalry around the other side of the city, because I had to go all the way around in order to get them around the right way, because otherwise the cavalry were going to hit me.
Yeah.
My cavalry won the battle. Which is good. Let me guess, you've probably already finished a load screen.
Yep, I've been waiting for 40 seconds already.
Really?
Yeah.
I only just passed 50%.
Yeah, I'm just staring at the main campaign. Two minutes and 50 seconds. Yes, thank God.
Although, in my opinion, the first battle was going the best. The second one was by far the worst. Although, the desync in that one happened like in the first 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. And this one was sort of like in between.
Yep.
What do you think of Total War Warhammer? Oh, we killed it.
Oh, we did too. Holy fuck, he just got rinsed. You didn't destroy the... Oh, no. The other force ran away, right. Total War Warhammer. I don't know anything about Warhammer. I don't know anything about the lore or anything. I guess I'm excited for it. Something a little bit different. But I prefer historical settings, so...
Yeah, I prefer historical as well. But I think Warhammer could be good.
Yep. Do you know much about Warhammer?
I know a bit. Okay, so the Western Roman Empire is going to pay me 3,200 to join the war against the Saxons, who are ages away. I'm going to accept that.
Hmm. And it's not like I'm ignorant to fantasy. I love fantasy, like Game of Thrones and Lord of the Rings and stuff.
Yeah.
I just never got into Warhammer.
It's pretty good. Have you ever played the Dawn of War games?
No.
I reckon start with those. That's what I started with, yeah. And they were pretty fun.
Okay.
They're like not the best games, but they're pretty good. Yesterday I slammed my finger in a door. Now it hurts.
Right.
Fingernail's gone purple.
My ally just declared war on someone, called me to fight, and then they just asked for a peace treaty. The enemy. They know they're fucked.
If become you accept my puppet. That, you become untrustworthy.
Yeah. I was trying to think if you become my puppet state, but they're not going to accept it. No.
That's Cartley.
Yep. Non-aggressional pact, Axum, no. I'm going to probably declare war on you at some point. You slammed your finger in a door, you said.
Yeah, I did. It was pretty dumb. As I said previously, before, I think, that I'm excellent at Total War and bad at life.
Right. We've just hit 40 minutes on the timer. Did you want to end the party, or...? How long do you usually do your videos for?
Yeah, about 40 minutes is good. We got a pretty good battle in there. Maybe.
Yep.
Okay, cool. Well, do you want to do a sign-off?
Right, well, thank you very much for watching if you watched all the way through. My name has been Simsy, and the one and only Legend of Total War. Didn't someone want to say your name, right?
Yep, I'll see you next time, fuckers.
How are you going on that side? It's only tilts of pikemen. The general's way... No, it's not. I thought it was.
How many kills did that artillery get? Only a few.
How well are your archers doing? 98, 60.
Yeah, they're doing pretty 70. Well. Doing better than the Limitani. 30 kills, one of them.
Okay.
Our archers were actually getting quite a lot of kills, so it's good that we got rid of them, although they're pretty much out of ammunition.
Can you check how much the towers do? No.
No, can't check that.
Right. Their general, how many units has got that? 90.
Guys in Testudo.
In Alaric. Yeah, I'll put the rest in. Should I put the other guys in Testudo?
It doesn't make a difference at the point. I think we've won. We just got to kill the enemy general, and then we're all good.
Are you surrounded? We could charge him if you halt your archers.
Okay, I'm going to tell my archers to stop shooting. I don't think we need him. We just got to kill the enemy general. Kill him and we've won.
I'll get him to charge.
And pull him back so I don't lose the whole battalion.
There's only 65.
He's wavering, so that's good.
Come on, you bastard. 51, the pikemen are coming in.
Still shooting because I told him to stop.
The archers up the top are on the little clip you got going.
They should have stopped. Come on, kill that goddamn general. He's routed.
Just double time your cavalry back and get him here.
Yep, because if he dies, we win.
Right.
Not the greatest of battles, but still, getting rid of the Visigoths early on, I think, is a good move.
And Alaric's their heir, I think. Or was it Alaric?
Get rid of both armies.
Alaric was their king.
The other flank over there is not holding out so well. We've got to move back over there. All the infantry to the other flank.
We still haven't killed the general. I don't think.
Ah, what is there? One. There's two men left.
I'll get the explore archeries to double time. There's only two left. Come on. Piss off.
Come on, general. Get over here. They need morale.
Yep, we got him.
Good. I'm just going to run everyone down. We should be able to get a mass route going.
Come on, you bastards.
Hey, we've got both towers shooting over here.
Nice.
That's providing flaming shot. Also, if I use whistle shot with the archers, that'll like... Oh, wait, wrong ones. With these ones here.
Your general's about to engage. Just letting you know.
Yeah, I know.
Alright.
Alright, it's alright.
Okay.
Right over here. If they use whistling shot, it's going to cause morale penalties over everything. Come on, use the whistle shot.
They're starting to rout. Let's pull back in our favor now.
We've won.
Run them down. Those onagers are still there. No, they're gone now. Nice. Let's run these bastards down.
That's the way. Alright, now we just let the cavalry do their thing. So here we go, kills wise. Oh, it says that they've got no men, but that's not true.
No.
That just means no men still fighting. They're still alive.
Yep. So we only lost, how much did we lose? 1,000. That's not too bad. Well, you lost 1,000.
Yeah, it also got to keep into account units that shattered. They count as dead men. So I don't actually lose them, though.
Yep.
Still a lot of people got to go kill. Oh, they're exhausted. They're not going to catch up.
Yeah. The towers are picking them off as well, so that's working for you.
Yep, it's all good.
All good.
Okay, let's speed this up. I'm just going to... Yeah. I doubt this is actually going to destroy their faction, but the more damage we can do to them, the better. I might be able to run them down afterwards.
Hmm. Yeah. Did you kill the other...
Well, killing both
general coming in?
Generals isn't going to do anything, really. They'll just hire more. We could actually destroy their hordes.
Yeah.
So is your family always from Tasmania?
No. Mum's from Melbourne.
Oh, so you're not actually that inbred?
No, I'm only half inbred.
Oh, right. See, I'm actually from Melbourne as well.
Yeah. No, but my dad's full Tasmanian.
All right. Your dad, brother?
Yep.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, people keep asking me, like, I always complain about the heat here.
Mm-hmm.
In Queensland. I'm originally from Victoria, where it's actually nice.
Yeah. Hey, Melbourne's good.
Yeah. I was just like, I remember when I was 9 years old, my parents were like, guess what, we're moving to Queensland. And I was like, fuck off.
Jesus.
Like, do you want me to die?
It is hot up there. It's hot and sticky.
It's hot and sticky.
It's really weird, because I went to Europe last year, and it's a different heat, I swear. Like, in Italy, it's, like, not as bad as in fucking Queensland.
Yeah. I can't understand. Some people just love it here. I'm just like, what's wrong with you? Do you not sweat?
I got off the tarmac in Darwin, and my flip-flops were melting to the, like...
You call them flip-flops?
Thongs. I don't know.
You call them flip-flops because you're always talking to people from the UK. but I'm Australian, yeah. So you didn't call them flip-flops.
Yeah, I guess I was desensitized then. Yeah, I don't know why I said flip-flops. Thongs, yeah.
We have to use different language because of people from other...
But then the counter-argument to that is how many lives would they destroy? Like, I've saw people, well, like, saying that.
Yes, technically, but...
That's stupid.
You can understand that people take their own life when they have drugs, sort of.
Yeah. Wow, touche. Right, at least we can see in this battle.
Yeah, this is the first time it was foggy, shitty. Second time it was really rainy.
Yeah. Right, where are the reinforcements?
Archers are in really loose formation, which I don't like. I want them to tighten up. Wait a second. I got an idea. Get them in there.
Right.
Oh, they've got to go all the way around.
Do you have any questions about Tasmania?
What's there to know, apart from you're all inbreds?
Yep, there's I'm not even joking, there's actually inbreds here.
Yep.
Like, honestly. I'll tell you a story, I guess. My mum used to work as a nurse down in Hobart.
Is she just your mum, or is she also your sister? Sorry.
Fuck, that derailed me. Yeah, but no, there's actually like a little inbred colony, and yeah, they like live in the bush, yeah, in their own little community, and they have to drink lots of water for some reason. Okay. It's like they're like so inbred, like they have to drink like 6 liters of water a day or something stupid.
Why? Because they've got like holes in their skin. They've actually got gills that like pour out.
But yeah, no, honestly, there actually are inbreds here. It's proper fucked.
I believe you.
I'm not inbred. I'm fucking... Well, now me saying that questions it.
How do we know you're not inbred?
Oh, I don't have two heads.
Oh, okay. Because, I don't think anybody gets two heads when they're inbred. They like just get... They get a little bit extra or a little bit less.
Right, are these cohorts firing? They should be, they're not in range. I'll move them up. Are they in range?
Crap. Well, I'll tell you, in Queensland, we don't have inbreds. We, of course, have bogans. I'm sure you got bogans as well. But what we have is shriveled up prunes.
We have bogan inbreds.
Yeah, that's... Wow. That's...
In Australia, you're about to say. I'm used to it. We're technically connected, I think, under the sea.
Yeah, not connected by land.
We were connected.
When?
A while ago.
What, like when the Aboriginals first got here?
No, as in like geographically a long time ago, before it split.
Yeah,
like, not that long ago. Like
40,000 years, wasn't it?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
We're connected under the sea.
So is everyone. We're connected to bloody the USA by the sea.
Hey!
The sea.
Okay.
It's just much, much, much deeper.
Can you move your archers up a bit so I can move the cohorts in to get some shots off? Because if I put them in front of yours...
Well, they're kind of doing something.
Yeah.
They're also obstructed, sort of.
Yeah.
Where's this guy? Need to get him over here.
I was trying to think where I can get these cohorts to skirmish just a bit more.
Yeah, it's gonna be... get my cavalry around the other side.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
My archers.
Those archers will be able to rinse through there.
Because what I gotta do is kill their general, but I can't really get to him.
Where's their other one deploying? They're flanking quite heavily now. From that side.
Yeah, if you come to Queensland, you've been to Queensland before, haven't you?
Yeah, I go to Queensland about once every year. Go to the Sunshine Coast because my uncle lives there.
Your uncle? Or is he also your brother?
He's my dad.
Okay, right. Okay.
It could be my son, I don't know.
Uncle's son? How the hell does that work?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Okay, hang on. Your uncle is your brother's child. So if he's also your son... You had sex with your brother. No, or your sister.
Oh, no. Oh, cousin.
God, I don't even know how inbreeding works. You're gonna have to explain it to me. Sort of.
Fuck.
Okay, see, I've got my archers here on this sweet little angle here. You can see up there on the...
You just need to hope for a lucky shot if you can hit that general.
Yeah, plus the artillery is now hitting these guys up here, which is going to be far less accurate.
They're going to be breaking the wall mostly compared to your units.
That wall can't break, it's indestructible.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just like fucking idiots.
I need you to push more troops down there.
Get them to attack.
Yeah, you can't let them... Don't let them get up here. Don't let them take the tower, because a lot of these Libertani are about to break and die.
Do you want to put into Testudo, or...?
Just get him down there. I'm getting a bit overwhelmed here. Yeah, I'll send the general over. He needs to rally them. Shit.
Cohorts should be able to skirmish.
Oh, fuck's sake. Thought this would go a little bit better. It doesn't really matter if we do lose it, but...
How are we going? Lost 400, they've only lost 900, so...
Hang on. We can see that stuff, can't we? They've got still a lot more men than us, though. And don't forget, if we're all broken, what's that going to mean?
Are you just going to get them... Are you holding them or are you getting them to charge?
I'm just getting them in there. Essentially, it's the cavalry that's going to do all the real damage anyway. Just gotta buy us some time, because if we kill the enemy general, we'll make the other army rout as well. I'll send you to go.
I'll push them off a bit.
Oh no, it's right. I mean, what's this? Gothic levy, don't worry about them. Just go all the way around the side of the settlement for the cavalry to get here, because the other motherfuckers showed up there. It's 24 hours total war.
Hella.
In the middle of the act, and I'm like, ah, slaughter them! Instead of... Okay, that doesn't even make sense. That's actually not what happens.
What are you doing your turn-wise?
Turn-wise? What am I doing?
Mm.
I'm building stuff.
Okay.
I've actually got a lot more money than the previous ones because I managed to get more trading units. It all just depends on how much they like you to begin with. Oh, actually, the Franks say medium. I probably won't worry about them. I'm not going to pay them any cash.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to milk the AI for money in this. That's what Man's Soul found out.
Yeah, and now I'm just going through destroying things that I don't want, like rally fields.
Because what we... Yeah.
Military jetty, I don't think I need that.
Because we were playing as the Ostrogoths and the Visigoths. We fled to Africa. Everyone loved us. We were getting 2,000 per faction. Easy. So we're getting like nearly 10,000 per every five turns.
Oh God, it's fucking so crazy. Easy.
Yeah.
You don't have to worry about... Like, the thing is, as the Eastern Empire, the Sassanids are your biggest threat.
Yeah.
And now I don't have to worry about that.
Yeah. And, yeah, like I... Oh, well. I can give you money if you need to, and if you need an army, I can come over and help.
The thing is, I'm too proud to ask for money, and I'm too greedy to share any with you. Seriously, you will find me to be your worst ally ever. Okay, I'm done with my turn, I think. I might just hire a few extra units. I've got plenty of money coming in, but... cavalry's more... Ah, doesn't matter, that'll be fine. Edicts. I forgot about the edicts. So I'm going for food production and well and growth. Because that's important that we get those building slots going.
Is that a resource at Constantinopolis? That cross?
What?
Is that a resource?
A patriarchal see.
And what's that exactly?
Well, you're Catholic and you don't even know about the Pentarchy.
No, as in like the game.
Well, it's based off history. There are five...
Like, what are the bonuses? Seats.
Basically, there's five seats of Christianity. There's Alexandria, so that's the Coptic Christians. There's, I think, Jerusalem's supposed to be the other one, but they've renamed it to Aelia Capitolina here. Mm-hmm. There's Antioch, there's Constantinople, and then there's Rome, the five seats of... Basically, the five popes.
Yep.
And the Byzantine Empire has four of them. Rome has the fifth.
And what bonuses do you get from that? Do you get any?
Well, it allows you to build the Christian major building, the Greek Patriarchal See.
Yeah.
So the Greek Patriarchal See gives you access to religious influence, one state religion, all regions. But since you're getting rid of Christianity,
it's going to be useless.
It makes useless. Anyway, moving on to your turn. Yeah, the main reason to get rid of Christianity in this is, for one thing, the buildings are really expensive, and secondly, the Huns just wreck Christians.
Hmm.
Right. Okay, so we're getting attacked here. So this is...
Third time's a charm.
Third time, this is it. If we can get through this, we'll be doing well.
If not, I'm just going to flip shit.
Pop a new topic on you. You've been following the shit that's been going down in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. I have been.
Man, people are flipping out over that crap.
I know. What, do you want to know my opinion on it?
Oh, do you want to know my opinion first?
Yeah.
I don't care that they got killed.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'll just keep everyone up to date. Basically, there was a bunch of Australian drug smugglers that got caught in Indonesia. In Indonesia, the penalty for being caught for drugs-related things is often the death penalty. So the two ringleaders got... after being in prison for, like, 10 years...
Why was that? Why 10 years?
I don't know. I guess they want to rehabilitate them before they kill them.
Because that makes sense.
Yeah.
But anyway... Go on. Yeah,
they've been trying for ages and ages to get clemency. They didn't get it. And pretty much, I think it was yesterday, they were shot dead. And I don't care. Basically,
Fair enough.
The rest of Australia is just flipping the shit out over this crap.
Yeah, I agree with that. It's just fucked. The amount of people just... This Facebook statuses and newsfeed is just full of shit.
I know. Like, to be honest... I don't know, like, I just, like, I don't, I, it's hard, shit, it's hard to say, like, I kind of support the death penalty for things, but drug-related crimes is, like, not one of them.
And, they were importing to Australia, they got caught in Australia. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know they got actually caught in Australia. No, I thought Australian authorities tipped them off.
Oh.
Tipped off the,
Yeah, because apparently, Andrew Chan managed to smuggle over $2 million from Indonesia to Australia.
Yeah.
So, but they were the masterminds to it.
Yeah. I also found it funny that they made amends for their ways, or they became better people mm-hmm. once they were in jail, not before.
Yeah.
Sort of thing. I don't know. Like, I mean, you got to understand, like, everyone knows that in Indonesia, especially after Chappelle Corby crap,
mm-hmm.
If you pull any drug shit over there, you're going to risk your life. Yeah, I'll give you these three.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of against the death penalty, but I just...
Wuss.
Yeah.
That's all right.
I don't know. I just feel like it was kind of a waste. For drugs as well. Like,
yeah, look, for drugs,
but they did risk
it. I understand
it.
That, yeah.
The penalty has to fit the crime, but they were fucking idiots.
I think... Like I said, I support the death penalty for mm-hmm. murderers and rapists.
Yeah, because that makes sense.
Yeah, but like for drugs, which I don't really consider to be like the worst thing that's ever been invented.
Yeah, same.
Legend of Total War here, and I'm with Simpsy, and this is a co-op campaign for Total War Attila. How's it going, Simpsy?
Yeah, right. How are you?
Yeah, good.
We're playing.
Yeah.
Yep, we're playing as the Eastern Roman Empire and the Sassanids.
Yep, me being the Eastern Empire. So, we're not going head-to-head this time. Well, not that we've done head-to-head before. Because the head-to-heads, I think, in Attila are a bit boring.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, end up just with AI death. Like, if you've watched the campaign between me and Soul Games Inc., we weren't exactly enjoying it. And he was telling me that he was playing a co-op campaign with you, and that mm-hmm. it was actually fun.
Yeah.
So we're playing for fun more than anything else here. And also good conversation.
Sure. Especially with that head-to-head, you guys were just avoiding each other the whole time. Just
we never
running
touched
around.
Each other once.
That's what she said.
Yeah. Yeah, I Yes.
Sick.
Yes.
Right, I'm in now.
He did get raped at sea, though.
True.
Not by me, which is annoying because I wanted to do the raping. Then again, I got raped by the Romans.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so.
Okay, we're in.
You're in first.
Right. Firstly, I want to get trade rights with you. Boost up my economy naturally. I need to see what relations are with the Western Rome. It might be alright.
I don't think you'd be able to trade with them anyway, because you've got no clear path to get to them.
Yeah. No, I don't. But they are neutral. It's not too bad. Right.
If you can manage to, like, conquer your way up to Crimea, that'll give you a port by which you could trade with Rome.
Mm-hmm. I think that's probably the best thing for me. I can subjugate a lot more regions to the north.
Yeah.
All right. Military-wise, I think I'm going to go with military to get some better quality units. All right. Objective-wise, I'll just show you guys. What is it? I need 16 more puppets. We basically smashed everything else. Maintain 400 units. We currently have 109 and 16 technology. So this campaign and series, I wouldn't imagine, would go for very long.
It'll be a fun and quick one. Quick, fun campaign. We'll have a few cool battles and then call it a day.
Awesome. Right, okay.
I mean, guys, if you're looking for me to have a hard time in a campaign, check out the Western Roman Empire campaign.
Jesus.
I'm sweating bullets on that one. Is there any campaign you're having a tough time with?
I was at the start with the Danes campaign.
Yeah.
That was pretty hard, but I pushed through. I finished
That's
my Western...
That's what
she said. Oh, God. Go. Cheers.
It was pretty hard, but I pushed through. The anus. Okay, are you done your stuff?
No, man, I'm just quickly going through my buildings. Alright.
So, yeah. Obviously, you guys don't know this, because our video is screwed up. But this is actually our third attempt at starting this campaign. Desyncs.
Biggest pain in the ass.
Yeah. That's not what she said.
My God, this is
okay.
That's superb.
We're going.
This commentary is fucking sick, eh?
Yeah. You started the she said stuff.
Yeah, I know. God damn it.
And I tend to overkill these things, beat it right to the ground.
It's fine. Right, okay. Where are you pushing these bastards? My public order was real shit last time when I moved out, so I might not move everyone. Alright, quickly reform these armies, and I'll throw it back to you. Alright, that looks alright. Onigers here. What have I got? Light onigers. Since when did I have onigers? Alright.
All I have to say is, why would the Eastern Empire have allowed the Visigoths to enter into this area?
Is it, like, so far deep as well? Don't you fucking dare! Don't you fucking...
Oh, I didn't even need to say it that time.
Oh, I was so angry with myself.
Yep.
Right. I might need to put one more provincial governor in. Go with the minus corruption. Sanitation not really needed overly that much.
No, you don't need any sanitation buildings. All you need to do is take provincial capitals and then you'll be all good. I don't know how many provinces there are in the game, but let's just say there's 60 of them. So if the Sassanids take 60 provinces, they've got 60 sanitation in all settlements.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they'd probably have something like 140% corruption, but whatever.
True. Okay. It's your turn, mate. Jesus.
What?
Didn't even mean to do that.
What'd you do?
I don't know. It just sounded really Australian, I think.
Well, that's okay. Do you feel like you have to dial it down? Dial down the Aussie when you're talking to Soul Games Inc. or something?
No. Not necessarily. I don't know. Do I have that much of an Australian accent?
I don't know. It's a bit.
Yeah.
I can tell it's like if I walked by you in the street, go, he's definitely Australian.
Yeah.
I guess.
I don't know.
I feel like I don't have as much of an Australian accent as some people do.
I could definitely tell you were a Queenslander by your accent. I don't know why. Yeah, okay. Yeah, easy.
I've been told otherwise. But yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Maybe I've been told that by other Queenslanders.
True.
Yeah, and then there's also Bogan. Do you guys have Bogans in Tasmania, apart from inbreds?
We have Bogan inbreds.
Yeah. Oh, wow, Bogan inbreds, man, they must be fucked.
They are super fucked.
I'm sure there's viewers watching, they're like, what the hell's a Bogan?
Mm-hmm.
Just use your imagination or Google it, that's all I can say.
What's the equivalent? A chav in the UK, maybe?
I don't know. It's somebody who is at the bottom barrel of the evolutionary pit. Somebody who is on welfare, has no teeth, consumes alcohol for fuel, and has many, 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 many children.
Has a wife beater.
Yep, what and he got? Beats his wife.
Yep.
Oh, I guess you guys don't realize it. I'm getting rid of course, Christianity again. Because not only do I not like it in real life, but I don't like it in the game either. But to be honest, if it was better in the game, I'd leave it. But it gives the Huns a huge advantage over us. Okay, so we need governors.
So, controversial. Did you have a religious upbringing? Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have since unshackled myself from it.
Yep. Is it Catholic?
Of course it is.
Yeah, same here.
What else would it be? I think Australia is the most Catholic, most also unshackled Catholic country there is.
Yeah.
Like, you just walk down the street. Did you used to be Catholic? Yep. Used to being the key word. My whole family used to be Catholic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, same. It's interesting.
Yeah. Don't have a problem with Christians. I don't want to get too much into
it.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Yeah. It's a sensitive subject for most.
Fuck it.
Yeah. Oh, right, I've already got 4 out of 4 governors, right. That's why I can't get more. Gotta get more Imperium, which will make people hate me. Oh, speaking of Imperium, or people liking me, let's see, trade routes. I can get one with Abascia, possibly. Good. High successes. Let's give me some cash. Say about 1,100. So did you have to do the whole Catholic school, go to church every Sunday?
I wasn't that bad with going... Oh, yeah, not as bad as like full on, but I did go to a Catholic school.
Yep, so did I. Primary school and secondary school.
Yep.
And forced to go to church every Sunday. Stand up, sit down, stand up, sit down, kneel, sit down, stand up, kneel, sing, go home.
Yeah.
Thank fuck it's over.
I didn't have to go to church every Sunday, just on like special occasions and stuff.
Oh, okay. No, I was in one of those families where it was guilt. It was like, oh, if you did anything, you got to go to confession.
Oh, so it was full on.
It wasn't 100% full on. It was more full on when I was a kid, I suppose.
Yeah.
But naughty shit that I was, I was always in trouble. And it always used to piss me off when I'd get, like, because I would say something like, I don't want to go to church today. And then I would lose my computer privileges. Which is like the easiest way to make me have a tantrum.
Yeah.
You could probably imagine that I was a shit of a chid. Kid.
A chid.
Chid.
I had football on Sunday, so I got out of it mostly.
Yeah. My parents made the mistake of putting me on a computer when I was 5 years old. And then they were like, we can't get him off.
What have we done?
What have we done? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm, of course, the eldest, so I was the big bully of the... out of five.
Yeah?
Yep.
I'm the eldest out of four.
Yep. It's good to be the eldest.
Apart from, it's fucking sick.
Yeah. What am I doing? Okay, now I need food.
So what's your background then? As an Australian? Ethnic. Yeah, ethnic, I mean.
Half Maltese, half everything else.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Like, there's a bit of Scottish, there's a bit of Dutch.
Yeah.
There's a bit of English. Bit of this, bit of that.
Yep.
Yeah. So, I've been to Malta.
Mm-hmm.
That's about it. Okay, so I'm trying to fix up the food in all my regions, because we've got, like I said to you before, regions that are importing food lose 25% of their wealth, so it's important to fix that up straight away. Also, the more food surplus you have, the more growth you get in all of your provinces. But I'm sure you already know that.
Yep. All good.
How many hours you clocked on Attila?
180, I think.
Yeah, okay.
You had that within like the first couple of days. I was keeping count. I was looking at it.
Yeah, but to be honest, what I did was I never turned my computer off. So I like...
Oh, okay. Just
like,
left it
I'd
on.
I'd be there at like 11 o'clock at night, and then I'd be in the middle of a game or a video, and I'd just press end the video, and then I'd be like, going to bed, and I'd just walk straight to the bed. Didn't even bother turning off the computer. And then, of course, when I wake up, I'm like, oh man, I'm fucked. And then I come to the computer. It's like, oh good, it's still here. Pick it up. Sometimes I don't even have breakfast. It's like, oh, I gotta get my total war going. And of course, I only sleep for like 4 hours, of which I dream about killing.
Which you dream about total war?
Yeah.